Hello viewers, in this video we will see how to use DigiSpark development board. Some viewers don't know about DigiSpark and they may have a question that what is DigiSpark? It is a development board which uses 80 tiny 85 microcontroller. It is designed by DigiSTEM in such a way that it doesn't need any separate programmer. This development board has USB interface which is used to connect to the computer and program it directly. For using this development board, we have to download DigiSTEM driver which will help computer to detect DigiSpark board. So first open up your browser and search for DigiSTEM driver. Open this DigiSTEM GitHub link, scroll down a little bit and click digistem.driver.zip to download the drivers. Link of this driver is also given in the video description. After finishing your download, extract the downloaded zip file. Now open the extracted folder and install driver using dpinst.exe for 32-bit OS and dpinst64.exe for 64-bit OS. After that, we have to add DigiSpark board in the Arduino IDE. So now open the Arduino IDE. Then go to File, Preferences, and then in the additional board manager URLs, we have to enter this URL which is given in the video description. Then click OK. After that, we have to go to Tools, then Board Manager, and then search for DigiSpark and then install the DigiSTEM AVR boards. Now to program, we have to select DigiSpark board. So go to Tools, then Board, then scroll down and select DigiSpark default 16.5 MHz. Now we can upload our code. So let's open start example sketch from DigiSpark example. The way of programming DigiSpark board is different from regular Arduino boards. Before clicking upload button, unplug the DigiSpark board from computer and then click upload button. Arduino IDE will compile the code and then ask to plug the DigiSpark board within 60 seconds. Now plug the DigiSpark board into computer. The Arduino IDE will detect DigiSpark board and upload the code. In this way, you can upload your code into DigiSpark development board. If you have any trouble programming the board or you need support, you can ask in the comment section. Thanks for watching.